The oceans are really important to Australia. There's a couple of reasons. You know, economically, they're about 5% of our GDP, with oil and gas coming in about half of that. Tourism's about $11 billion, with fisheries and aquaculture about $3.4 billion. And then there's ports and shipping. Globally, that's roughly about the same. But if you think about what it actually means to Australians, it's a lot more than that. It's a big part of our culture. We're one of the few countries in the world, say, that has so many recreational fishes. About one in every four Australian households goes recreational fishing a year. That's roughly 3.5 million people. So when you start to add that in and all of the services it provides, it's nearly half of our GDP, $700 odd billion, if you have to put an economic value on it. But you know, it's close to people's hearts. I think it's part of our identity. The changing climate's impacting our oceans in a lot of ways. So when we talk about climate change, the biggest part of that's been to the ocean. So climate warming is actually ocean warming. The greatest part of warming is in the oceans. They see it a lot faster than the rest of the world, particularly in parts of Australia. We have some of the world's hotspots for ocean warming, particularly in southeastern Australia. The oceans are also becoming more acidic. So all the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere gets sucked up into the ocean and makes it much more acidic for the life that lives there, which has potential to affect their shells. Physiologically, it has effects, so animals don't grow as big when the oceans are warmer. They're more vulnerable to predators. So that has knock-on effects through fisheries and how we use the oceans. CSIRO is doing quite a lot of research into oceans and climate, what that means for Australia and the globe. So our team consists of people who are comfortable with numbers. So using maths as a language to describe the world is what we do. And then we effectively make science-based computer games. So you know, how does it all link together inside the computer? But that's dependent on hundreds of other scientists. So we just bring together sources of information from every part of the system. So there's hundreds of thousands of different data streams that come together in the computer. So you know, we're the big number crunchers at the far end. So we have to include the people in the system too, the coastal communities and how they use the systems, but also the other industries and how they make their decisions. Ecosystem-based management is about taking a holistic approach to management. So thinking about all the different parts of the system simultaneously, so right from the ecological and environmental sides through to the human uses and particularly how they interact. For instance, the research that I work on is using ecosystem models, so models of the oceans and the humans and all the different parts of that world, and running it forward to see what that world might look like, and trying to find best ways of adapting to that world. Do we need to change management? Do we need to change how we fish or where we fish? So if you think of every part of the system, the CSIRO has some research into each part of that system and how it's changing due to climate, but lots of other factors as well. So climate's just one part of what's called global change, which is all the different ways that humans are interacting with the Earth and changing how it functions. So we inform decision making by playing out the alternatives. So we look at what the alternative futures could be and we play them forward and we see where they meet what people want. So we have discussions with people like decision makers and politicians, but also community members and industry, picturing alternative futures so that people can get an idea of how the decisions they make today might affect what that future looks like.